As you know, the all-new 2022 Ford Maverick has just made its world debut. And that means that the mini truck, compact pickup wars are in full swing. What do I mean by this? Well, for 2022, there are now going to be two compact pickup trucks on sale. The first one to market is likely to be the 2022 Hyundai Santa Cruz. And then in the fall of 2021, just a little bit later, the Ford Maverick should be reaching dealerships. In this video, I'm gonna give you a spec-by-spec comparison between the Maverick and the Santa Cruz. So let's get right to it. Let's start out with the size and what they really are. They are crossover unibody-based pickup trucks, four doors crew cab with a short bed. Both of them start out on a front-wheel drive platform, and both of them offer all-wheel drive. The Maverick, in this case, is a little bit longer truck, actually, and a little bit taller. The total length on the Maverick is about 199 inches, just under 200 inches long, which makes it just about as long as a Ford Explorer, for example. And, of course, the Hyundai Santa Cruz is about 195.7 inches long, so about 4 inches shorter than the Maverick, and both of them are based on a compact crossover. The Maverick is based on the architecture that also underpins the Ford Escape and the Ford Bronco Sport, and the Hyundai Santa Cruz is based on a Hyundai Tucson chassis. And also, both of them offer several powertrain options. The Ford Maverick is available from the get-go as a base truck with a 2.5-liter hybrid powertrain with a CVT, which is a very unique proposition for any pickup. And of course, it gives great fuel economy. So let's take a look at the hybrid Maverick first, and then let's take a look at the powertrain and the Santa Cruz. So the Maverick base powertrain produces a total of 191 horsepower and 155 pound-feet of torque, for a combined fuel efficiency estimate of 37 mpg. Yes, this is a front-wheel drive little pickup with 37 mpg. On the flip side, the Santa Cruz also has a 2.5-liter naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine, but this one is not a hybrid. There is no electric motor involved here. It's an 8-speed automatic, and front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, while the hybrid Maverick is only front-wheel drive. And the power is about the same, 190 horsepower in the Santa Cruz for the base motor, and it's a little bit more torquey there, 180 pound-feet of torque in the Santa Cruz base model for a combined rating of 23 mpg. So if you take a look, about the same horsepower. The Santa Cruz is a little bit more torquey, but the Ford Maverick Hybrid has way higher fuel efficiency from the get-go. Let's take a look at capability. And here, the Santa Cruz has a slightly upper edge. The Santa Cruz in the base form is rated to tow about 3,500 pounds, and with an optional turbocharged engine, is rated to tow about 5,000 pounds maximum. On the flip side, the Maverick Hybrid base truck is rated to tow about 2,000 pounds and then 4,000 pounds with a turbocharged optional engine in the Maverick. So why does the Maverick have lower towing capability? Well, I think it has something to do not technically with the chassis, but also how it fits into the lineup. The Ford has a full range of pickup trucks because there is also the Ford Ranger, the Ford F-150, the Ford Super Duty, then the Ford medium duty, really heavy commercial trucks. And there's a lot of choice in pickup truck for Ford. On the Hyundai side and for Kia, this is their only pickup truck. So I think what's happening here, and this is my opinion, is that Hyundai actually wanted to give the Santa Cruz a little bit more capability because it's kind of their only offering, and that they wanted to do a lot of different things. On the flip side, Ford also has the Ford Ranger. So if you want more towing capability, if you want more off-road capability, you could step up slightly higher and go for the Ford Ranger or other trucks in the Ford lineup. Same story approximately is with the payload. The Santa Cruz is rated at the maximum payload of 1,748 pounds. This is a lot. This is a high payload. But there's a caveat here. Hyundai says only about 660 pounds can be in the bed. So the bed has its own rating, and then the whole vehicle has its own rating. On the flip side, Ford says 1,500 pound maximum payload, still pretty good for a compact, But they also say, Ford says that 1,500 pounds can be placed into the bed. So they designed the Maverick truck to really truly be a little truck that's capable of a lot of work. And they also said they worked, you know, very carefully in the tie down points. All of them are pretty heavy duty, designed in a very similar way. Some other trucks are designed with Ford, for example, the Super Duty tie down points. So they spent a lot of time there. I interrupt this video for this week's TFL Bids Bargain. As you know, we have many trucks and off-road SUVs for sale, but this one is a true no expense spared overland build. It's a 2006 Land Cruiser 100 Series ARB Special. It's got special suspension, bumpers, a winch, and too many accessories to mention, including a fridge and a storage solution in the rear. Check it out, use the link below in the description, bid on this one, and don't forget, you can submit your truck or SUV by clicking the Submit a Vehicle button right there on the site. Then finally, the bed length. The maximum length actually in the Santa Cruz bed, technically they say it's 4 feet long, but the floor of it is about 52 inches long, which is a little bit longer than 4 feet. Ford bed, they say it's 4.5 foot long bed, but it's technically 54 inches. So they're kind of close. Ford has a slightly upper edge, and obviously if you flip the tailgate down, Ford will also offer a bed extender, so you can have that. And Hyundai offers a optional tonneau cover, which is kind of a roll-up cover, which is really cool and weather-tight solution. And of course, the Ford Maverick offers kind of the subdividers in the bed, places where you can put like a 2x6 or a 2x4 to subdivide your bed in different ways. That they call it flex bed, although this is not a new idea. My 2002 Chevy Silverado had the same feature in its bed with little slots that you can subdivide. Now let's talk about optional powertrain, because both of them offer turbocharged engines. And let's also talk about kind of off-roadability of both of these little pickups. So the Maverick will be offered with an optional 2-liter EcoBoost 4-cylinder engine with 250 horsepower and 277 pound-feet of torque in front-wheel drive or all-wheel drive configurations. And Santa Cruz will be offering a 2.5-liter, so higher displacement turbocharged engine with an 8-speed dual-clutch transmission. So Ford is using the traditional automatic here, and Hyundai is using a dual clutch transmission here. The Hyundai engine is a little bit more powerful, 275 horse and 310 pound-feet of torque. And we do know the fuel efficiency on this Hyundai Santa Cruz powertrain, which is about 22 combined MPG. We don't know that number on the Ford yet. But once again, what appears to be happening here is Ford is using basically a Bronco Sport optional turbo engine, and also that engine is available in the Escape as well. And they don't want to push it too high in the horsepower, so not to step on the Ford Ranger once again, which is just above that. And like I said before, the turbo engine in the Maverick will tow about up to 4,000 pounds, and about Santa Cruz about 5,000 pounds there. So Santa Cruz has a slightly higher towing rating. But if you're buying a compact pickup like this, you're probably not towing very heavy. So I think they're almost equal in this respect. Now let's touch on off-road capability. And we haven't driven any of these trucks yet. They're not available for sale, but we do have some specifications. They actually have identical ground clearance spec. So both the Maverick and Santa Cruz offer 8.6 inches of ground clearance. Is that really good? Well, no, it's not super great for a pickup truck. 8.6 inches is approximately where other crossovers are. For example, like a Subaru Outback, or sometimes like a Toyota RAV4 will offer very similar ground clearance. It's also similar to what's available in Bronco Sport and the Hyundai Tucson. So not super dramatic ground clearance here. Ford is offering FX4 off-road package. So yes, this is really cool because it's also offering aggressive tires, some extra underbody protection, specially tuned shocks, no extra ground clearance, and there is not currently, you know, they didn't announce anything else above the FX4, so there is no Tremor, Raptor, Badlands, nothing like that yet. But I'm happy to see that the FX4 is there for the Maverick, and it will offer unique driving modes for slippery and off-road conditions. On the flip side, on the Santa Cruz, so once again, similar ground clearance, the DCT, the dual clutch transmission, in our experience in the past, is not as good as a traditional automatic off-road. Sometimes those dual clutches tend to overheat a bit with really slow crawling. So they don't like to crawl at slow speeds. So you have to be mindful of that. And Santa Cruz, other than that, has an excellent, excellent all-wheel drive system. Very high-tech stuff. So both of them will do light off-roading. Nothing crazy, though, because their approach departure angles and breakover angles are not super, super high and super great. So that's what's going on with off-road capability. What about price? Well, Hyundai hasn't announced pricing yet, but Ford did. And this is kind of a shocker because it will start before destination charges at $19,995. And this is for the front-wheel drive hybrid, obviously with destination charges, that will be about, what, $21,490. And then, of course, with options and all-wheel drive and the optional engine, it could go into mid-30s potentially from there. Santa Cruz pricing is not known yet, but I kind of doubt they will come in at 20 grand, maybe slightly bit higher, but they could surprise us too. So pricing is quite similar, or potentially will be similar. And also, if you're wondering, the reason why I did not mention the Honda Ridgeline in this comparison is because Honda Ridgeline is truly a mid-sized pickup, crossover pickup also, because it's based on a Honda Pilot, and it's much bigger. It's about 11 inches bigger or longer than the Maverick and or the Santa Cruz, and it's wider, and it's just, it has a V6 engine, higher price, about $36,000 starting price, and also higher capability and higher, actually bigger bed. So I did not touch on the Ridgeline in detail for that reason. But these compact trucks, the Maverick and the Santa Cruz, are going to be available in a couple months. And we're going to have all the reviews of those trucks right here on tfltruck.com. You can go to the website and check it all out.